Welcome to Civil Engineering Online, Design of Fused Concrete Structures. Today's topic is Design of Sections of Power Flexure, Numerical on Design of Flexure. I am Ravi B. Telaganji for the video session. In this session, we will see the numerical problems on the post-tensioned unbounded tendons. A post-tensioned beam with unbounded tendons is a rectangular section 400 mm wide with an effective depth of 800 mm. The cross-sectional area of the pre-stressing steel is 2840 mm. The effective pre-stress in the steel after all losses is 900 Newton per mm square. The effective span of the beam is 16 meters. If FCK is equals to 40 Newton per mm square, estimate the ultimate moment of resistance of the section using IS 1343 code recommendations. One point we have to note down in this problem is post tensioned beam with unbounded tendons. So this will change the table which we have to see through the IS 1343 provisions. So let us begin with the solution part. Given data, noting down from the question, FCK 40 Newton per mm square, B 400 mm, D 800 mm, FPE is equals to 900 Newton per mm square, AP 2840 mm square, L by D ratio, that is length to depth ratio, it is 16 meters divided by depth of 800 mm. It comes out to be 16,000 divided by 800 as 20, the L by D ratio. Figure, if we are imagining the figure for the particular question, is like in this format: breadth 400 mm, depth 800 mm, total width is of 16 meters. Now the effective reinforcement ratio is given by ERR is equals to FPE AP divided by FCK BD. Substituting the values into this part is 0.20, we are able to have the effective reinforcement ratio. Referring to IS 1343, table 12, page number 60. On page number 60, this table is what we are able to have, wherein in this table it is given that post tension rectangular beams having unbounded tendons. This column is of effective reinforcement ratio, and here 6 columns are of 30, 20 and 10 is the effective span to effective depth ratio which we have to consider. The first three columns are for FPU divided by FP, and the next part of three columns are for XU by D values. So with respect to effective reinforcement ratio, we have to consider the values also with respect to span to depth ratio, that is L by D ratio. The corresponding value of effective reinforcement ratio 0.20 from the figure, what we are able to get means from the graph table of IS 1343, table number 12, 0.2 is the effective reinforcement ratio, and FPU by FP value what we are able to find is 1.6 from this particular column we are taking, because we are having effective span by depth ratio as 20. Similarly, XU by D as 0.58 from the column number 6, wherein the effective span by depth ratio is 20 and effective reinforcement ratio is 0.2, corresponding value is 0.58, which we are able to take into the account. Flexural strength of the section we are going to calculate for further section. Therefore, FPU is equals to 1.16 into 900, which comes out to be 1044 Newton per mm square, and XU is equals to 0.58 multiplied by depth 800 mm, it comes out to be 464 mm. Hence, flexural strength of the section for the rectangular section is given by, therefore, MU is equals to FPU multiplied by AP into bracket D minus 0.42 XU. Therefore, calculating Substituting the values, we calculate the mu value as 1794 into 10 raised to 6 Newton mm, which can be written in terms of kilonewton meter as 1794 kilonewton meter. Hence, this is the flexural strength of the section. So, this was the question number 4. Moving to question number 5 of the session, a post-tensioned bridge girder with unbonded tendons is of box section of overall dimensions. So, overall dimensions of a box section girder is given 1200 mm wide and 1800 mm deep with wall thickness of 150 mm. The box section is, means the rectangular section of box is present. High tension steel has an area of 4000 mm square and is located at an effective depth of 1600 mm. The effective pre-stress in the steel after all the losses is 1000 Newton per mm square and the effective span of the girder is 24 meters. If FCK is equals to 40 Newton per mm square and FP is equals to 1600 Newton per mm square, estimate the ultimate flexural strength of the section is the question. So in this, again, post-tensioned bridge with unbonded condition, so it has to be taken with table 12 of IS 1343, which is on page number 60. Solution, without waiting, given data, FCK 40 Newton per mm square, FPE 1000 Newton per mm square, B 1200 mm, D BW, that is two walls will be coming for the width of each wall is 150 mm. So total of two walls will be as 300 mm. D is 1600 mm, the effective depth. DF, depth of the flange, will be 150 mm. FP as 1600 Newton per mm square, which will be considered for the particular thing. It is 1000 Newton per mm square. Further part of the given data is AP as 4000 mm square is the particular data is in this. Now, to have a figure of this particular box girder, which we are able to see, this is as the box girder, bit not clear, but I am able to explain this part. The depth is 1800 mm, width is 1200 mm, wall thicknesses are of the box are as 150 mm overall thickness. This part is having the hollow section of the box section and total span of the box is 24 meters. So with 24 meters and depth of 1600 mm, we are going to calculate the length to depth ratio, which comes out to be 15 as the ratio of length to depth. So with this ratio and this data, moving for further solution in the part wherein now we need to follow the steps as below, because neutral axis is lying in the web, not in the flange. If the neutral axis is lying in the flange, it will be having simple rectangular section, but now the neutral axis is in the part of web, which we can see in this part of particular section. So because of this neutral axis in the web, we have to go with the second part of solution. So directly moving with the second part of solution, that is this part of steps we need to follow, is AP is equals to APW plus APF. APF is equals to this particular formula, 0.45 FCK into bracket BF minus BW into bracket DF divided by FP. Substituting the values of AP requirement, we find out APF as 1.58 into 10 raised to 3 mm square. Now calculating the APW, that is area of pre-stress in the web, AP minus APF, 4000 minus 1518, 2482 mm square is the value of area of pre-stress in the web. Thus, effective reinforcement ratio, now calculating with the formula of APW FP divided by BW FCK D, substituting the values in terms of this, we are able to have the effective reinforcement ratio as 0.129 we can take it as a round off of 0.13 also. I am keeping it as it is 0.129 for giving you a detailed discussion and calculation part. Referring to IS 1343 table 12 page number 60. So this is the table which is provided on table page number 60. The table has having post tension rectangular beams and unbounded tendons, which is discussed what all is given in this particular data. Now in our problem we are having a effective depth span to depth ratio as 15, which is in between 10 and 20. Here also we are having 10 and 20 in between the two values. Now in between values we need to find out. So what data we are going to take for the value of L by D as 20 and 10, both the values we have to consider. So considering FPU by FP, the first data in the particular box, and XU by D in this particular box. So FPU by FP and XU by D for 20, 15, 10, we have to incorporate. So for 0.1 of effective ratio, that is 1.26, 1.45 in XU by D, 0.32 and 0.36 is the value. Similarly, 0.129, which we require with the exact problem, is not able to have. I have made it as M in FPU by FP and M in XU by D. And the final 0.15, which value we are able to get it from the table, is 1.2, 1.36, and in XU by D 0.46 and 0.52. Now we need to get this M and N value with the help of interpolation. So moving for the interpolation part. As we have the effective reinforcement ratio of 0.1, interpolating value for this of L by D 15. So 1.26, 1.45, this is the part of interpolation which we did, and therefore FPU by FP 1.355 for L by D ratio of 15. So with the ratio of L by 10 and 10, 20, we are interpolating the value, which we are able to get this part of value of 15 as 1.355 for 0.1 effective reinforcement ratio. Similarly, we find out for effective reinforcement ratio of 0.15 interpolating of FPU by FP with effective span to depth ratio as 15. This substitution, when we calculate with interpolation, we get 1.28, which will be incorporated at this particular value. Now in between these two, we are resting with the value of M, which again we are going to interpolate with these values and effective reinforcement ratio. So that value and for 0.129 is what we required, and interpolating with these ratios and values, we find out this as 1.32, which will be here at this particular position. 1.32 is the what value we require to for the solution of the problem. Similarly, XU by D is also made for L by D of 15 and effective reinforcement ratio of 0.129. So this is for 15, which we have calculated the effective reinforcement ratio. So XU by D 0.34 for L by D of 15, and for the other part, second part, which is L by D of 15, we get 0.49 is the value. XU by D 0.49 for L by D 15. Interpolating between 0.1 and 0.15, between 0.49 and 0.34, this value we are able to get it as 0.427, which we are going to use in the further calculation part. So hence the values FPU by FP is 1.32 and XU by D as 0.427. Substituting and calculating the values of FPU will come as 1320 Newton per mm square, and XU as 0.427 multiplied by 1600, 683.2 mm. Hence the flexural strength of the section we are going to calculate. MU with the formula of FPU APW D minus 0.42 XU plus 0.45 CK D minus BW DF D minus 0.5 multiplied by DF. So substituting the values of the known values of these particular data and calculating the flexural strength with the respect to MU. So flexural strength of total comes out to be 7971.6 × 10⁶ Nm, which can be written as 7971.6 kN·m. So hope you all have understood the problems. This is the final topic for design of flexure. See you in the next topic with new module. Thank you for watching. Please like, share and subscribe the channel for more updates. Thank you so much.